This is a special update because of the strong earthquake that occurred yesterday in the Marmara Sea. And in this update, I will analyze the Marmara Fault, historical earthquakes that occurred in the region, and the potential threat for a future larger earthquake. So, yesterday, a magnitude 6.2 earthquake occurred in the middle of the Marmara Sea. And if we analyze the fault that runs through the Marmara Sea, this is the main Marmara Fault, we can distinguish three types of sections. And this analysis comes from the GFZ Potsdam in Germany. And this is a recent analysis. We have in the middle a transition zone. That's where the magnitude 6.2 earthquake occurred. And in 2019, September, there was a magnitude 5.7 earthquake in the same region. But there seems to be a trend towards the east with these stronger earthquakes. Yesterday, there were aftershocks, two magnitude 5 earthquakes. And one of them occurred to the east. And that's where we see the red line. And that is the locked zone. And to the west, we also see a locked zone. Then in between, we see a creeping zone. And that's where small earthquakes occur frequently, very small earthquakes. Often, we don't detect or feel. Well, we detect them, but we don't feel them. They are very small. And that's where you see the small dots there, that is west of the transition zone. What is concerning is that in the transition zone, we see the stronger earthquakes. And to the east, we see the locked zone. And that is completely locked. If we look at historical earthquakes, in 1509, there was a major earthquake in that locked zone. And it probably ruptured at least part of the zone. A lot of damage in Istanbul at the time. It was 1509. Since then, no major earthquake occurred along that locked zone. In 1766, there was a major earthquake, but occurred in the western part of the Marmara Sea, the Marmara area. And in 1912, in the same region as in 1766, there was also a major earthquake. So there seems to be a shorter recurrence time in the western part of the Marmara area. If we look at the major earthquakes in the 20th century, starting with the 1912 earthquake in the western part, we see also major earthquakes to the east of Marmara and to the east of Istanbul. And that's the North Anatolia Fault. And from 1939 to 1999, there were a series of major earthquakes propagating from east to west, culminating with the magnitude 7.6 earthquake in 1999. Devastating earthquake as well. And we see the Marmara area in between with no major earthquake since 1509. That is the eastern part, and that's concerning. So what is the chance of a major earthquake? Well, there are two scenarios right now. We have the 6.2 magnitude earthquake. It is possible that it relaxes that particular fault section for the time being, which means that we have aftershocks in the magnitude 3, magnitude 4 range, maybe even magnitude 5, but they will subside in time and there will be no larger earthquake for the time being. That's one scenario. The other scenario is that because of a change in stress distribution, because of that strong earthquake yesterday, there is an increased risk of a larger earthquake. And the concerning part is the locked zone south of Istanbul, because the last time that a major earthquake happened there was in 1509. If we look at history, the last 2,000 years, we know that probably in the year 989, there was also a major earthquake in that eastern part along that locked zone. There are indications based on research that there was a major earthquake in 989. And that could indicate a recurrence time of approximately 500 years. And that means that we could be due for another major earthquake. Now, when it is it most likely to occur, nobody knows. It could happen this year. It could happen in 5 or 10 years. There is no certainty. It very much depends on the stress in the fault zone, the critical stress, and whether or not it has reached a tipping point. We cannot measure that. There's no way to know. What we do know is, based on our own research, that these major earthquakes tend to occur with specific planetary geometry. And that's what we analyze in our weekly updates. For example, in 1509, there were major red-purple peaks preceding that major earthquake. And that's very typical geometry preceding these large earthquakes. If we look at 2023, with the major earthquake in February, we also see the red and purple peaks next to full moon clustering there on 4-5 February. And that indicates the potential of larger seismic activity following those peaks. And that's exactly what happened on 6 February. So that's what we monitor to indicate potential critical days. And it was also the case yesterday on the 22nd and the 23rd in the latest update. There was a convergence of critical geometry on the 21st and the 22nd. And I estimated that there could be clustering of stronger earthquakes, especially in the higher 5, low 6 magnitude range on the 22nd and the 23rd. And that's exactly what happened. On the 22nd, we had a 6.2, and also yesterday in the Marmara Sea. So these models, the SSGI models, they work quite well. Also, we track atmospheric anomalies, and on 5 April, Western Turkey was marked. We are still working on the expiration date of these anomalies. This is a fairly new technology. It's still in its infancy, and it looks like a 2021 days seems a valid period for an expiration date. If we look at December and January, there were magnitude 7 earthquakes, also 20 days after atmospheric anomalies were recorded. So in this particular case, we were actually too quick with removing these anomalies on 5 April. You can track the atmospheric anomalies that we measure. There's a live feed on our website. For example, this is what we recorded on 5 April. We clearly see the peaks. Normal measurements show a gradual curve, a relatively smooth curve. And when those peaks occur there in between, we measure that. We measure the millivolts. And in this particular case, it was 1.5 millivolts. That means higher 5, low 6 magnitude. It wasn't too strong. More information about these atmospheric anomalies are on the website. So, in a nutshell, what is the situation in Marmara? The Eastern Marmara region is locked. There's no doubt about it. The last time a major earthquake occurred in that area was in 1509. And that means that the region could be due, maybe even overdue, for a major earthquake. And that means earthquake preparedness as much as possible. And that may be difficult for many people in Istanbul, but earthquake preparedness is essential. Last-minute earthquake warning systems, your smartphone, earthquake apps, that can help. It is not really a matter of if, but when. And like I said, it could be this year, it could be in 5 years, it could also be in 10 years. A 2004 study, that's 2004, this is more 20 years ago, estimates that this particular lock zone has a 30 to 70% probability of a major earthquake in the next 30 years. That is from 2004 to 2034. So it is possible that we're getting close to such a major earthquake near Istanbul. It isn't good news. The fault section in the Eastern Marmara Sea is locked. We know that. And the recent activity yesterday, like I said, maybe it subsides for the time being. Maybe it's a precursor to a larger earthquake. Nobody knows with certainty because we cannot measure the stress levels in the Earth's crust. We don't know whether or not that fault section, that locked zone, has reached the tipping point. But we keep track of planetary geometry and atmospheric anomalies. They are the tools that we use to anticipate larger earthquakes. So be sure to check out the latest updates on the website and also the weekly videos. This is the special update. Stay safe. Until next time.